Nancy Pelosi's Labor Day message is so out of touch, it's unbelievable. Liberal Speaker of the House Nancy Pelosi isn't well known for her relatability, but her Labor Day post has reached a whole new level of out of touch. The speaker posted on Twitter, "Over generations, working people across America built the middle class and secured progress for hardworking families," Pelosi wrote. "House Democrats are unified in our commitment to America's working families. Happy Labor Day." It did not go over well. Her comments were flooded by users who expressed their disgust with Pelosi's support of the economic shutdowns that have hurt middle-class families and torched the speaker for her recent maskless visit to a San Francisco hair salon closed to the public. One user responded, "Is this the same middle class that set you up or nah?" Another wrote simply, "Nice hair." Others were more nuanced in their attacks, quoting Treasury Secretary Steve Mnuchin's criticism of Nancy for refusing to negotiate on coronavirus relief bills that would help millions of the small business owners she claims to support. No denying the tweet was a huge fail for Pelosi. Maybe it was just another setup. The Biden campaign just broke a new record, and it has some conservatives worried. Despite steadily declining polling numbers across the board, new reports show Joe Biden's campaign raised a record-breaking amount of money in August. In a Fox News exclusive, it was revealed that though the Trump campaign raked in $210 million for the month, the biggest month for the Republicans to date, they trailed far behind Joe Biden and the Democrats during the same period. Biden raised an unprecedented $364.5 million in August. While both campaigns have raised massive amounts of money, Biden's huge gains in fundraising may indicate a growing momentum no one really expected. Combined with the near-constant insistence by the fake news that the Trump campaign is strapped for cash, the news has some conservatives panicking as the clock ticks down towards Election Day. President Trump, though, doesn't seem concerned with the fundraising gap. He told reporters this week that he would be happy to personally fund his 2020 campaign like he did in 2016, if that became necessary. New survey shows how Americans are feeling about mail-in voting, and it may surprise you. In the midst of the coronavirus pandemic, lawmakers have urged mail-in ballots for the entire population. This is a whole new way of participating for many voters, and a new survey shows few are confident in the process. According to the Washington Post, fear of the coronavirus and doubts about the reliability of mail voting after months of attacks from President Trump are weighing heavily on Americans as they decide how to safely ensure their vote will be counted in this fall's presidential election. While they attempt to blame Trump's rhetoric for the skepticism, they admit that just over 3 in 10 say they are very confident that their vote will be counted accurately if they vote by mail, which, of course, suggests a number of Democrats may be concerned too, not just Trump followers. And perhaps voters have a reason to be worried. A bipartisan electoral reform commission has validated the concerns, concluding that mail-in voting increases the risk of fraud. The commission report also said that mail-in voting raises concerns about privacy, as citizens voting at home may come under pressure to vote for certain candidates. Not much information exists to ease the concerns of uneasy voters out there. There's no doubt the lack of confidence will lead to an interesting contest in November.